So before we talk about data federation, let's do a quick recap of what we've done so far. We started with some design files in MicroStation. We pushed them into the iModel hub, and then from there we pulled them into an iTwin viewer. And then we started customizing our iTwin viewer to change up the visualization of the model. And now we're going to be connecting it to a smart device database. And this whole process of adding that smart device database to our digital twin is what data federation is. What is the digital twin though? Is it the iModel? Is it the iTwin viewer that we're pulling our iModel into? Or is it this data connection we're adding? So digital twin is all of those things. Think of the design files that we pushed in into the iModel hub. That's like planting a seed. And the digital twin from there can grow. And writing code within our iTwin app is kind of like watering that seed, and then adding those external connections is what helps it to grow into a tree. And that entire tree is our digital twin. And just to take the analogy home, the iTwin platform is the fertile soil that your digital twin can grow on. And there's no limit to how much it can grow. You can keep adding new connections to further build the value of your digital twin. So the digital twin is not a static entity. It's something that's constantly evolving and growing. So let's take a few examples of these data connections. So in the beginning of the course, we saw a smart wind farm that we worked on. So in that case, the way we grew our digital twin was by adding real-time sensor data that gave us the live output of each individual wind turbine. And using that, we got the total energy production of the entire wind farm at any given moment. And then we added another data connection to get the historic data of the wind farm to keep track of the total power production in the past. And just to take it even further, we added yet another connection for future prediction through machine learning, using which we were able to predict the future energy production of the wind farm as well. So the more connections we added, the smarter our wind farm became, and the more value we were able to build for our digital twin. Another example is a digital twin of an office building that we did, and then we added a data connection to an HR database, using which we were able to keep track of the seating chart inside the entire office, assign colleagues with new workstations when needed, and also keep track of the total available office space. Yet another example is a digital twin of a plant that we did, which we connected to a specification sheet database. So anytime we highlight an element, so let's say a pump, we can pop open the specification sheet for that particular unit. And these examples are just the beginning. There are infinite possibilities here of how you can grow your digital twin. And that is the very heart of data federation. And the best part about this is that you don't have to keep multiple copies of your data. Your application meets the data where it is. These additional databases immersively connect into your app without any additional upkeep. At this point, I think we have a pretty good understanding of not just data federation, but how your digital twin grows. So let's go ahead and grow ours and connect it to that smart device database.